गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी विल कंटिन्यू चैप्टर नंबर 6, वर्ल्ड आफ्टर 1945। सो बिफोर वी स्टार्ट अ न्यू टॉपिक, लेट अस रिवाइज क्विकली दैट व्हाट वी रेड इन प्रीवियस वीडियो। सो इन प्रीवियस वीडियो वी केम टू नो दैट व्हाई यूएन वाज फॉर्म एंड व्हाट आर द गोल्स ऑफ यूएन। सो यूएन वाज फॉर्म ऑन 24th October 1945. And the main goal of United Nations was to maintain peace and harmony in the world. So today we will continue our chapter number 6, World After 1945, and today we will read a new topic in this. So the next topic is Cold War 1945 to 1962. Here we will read what were the reasons and consequences of Cold War. Students, Cold War was started from 1945 and ended in 1962. Basically, this was an era where two superpowers continuously upgraded their arms and ammunitions. Let us read the paragraph and understand what was the Cold War and reasons and consequences. Though the World War II got over, it resulted into creation of America and Russia as superpowers while taking the place of England and France. So after the World War II, America and Russia were the two superpowers taking the place of England and France. Before the World War II, England and France were superpowers, but after the war, the superpowers were America and Russia. In war, England, France, Russia and America were together, but Russian administration policies created differences and thus America and England separated. A strong competition between the two superpowers, America and Russia, to establish supremacy over the world emerged after Second World War. So after the war, England, France, Russia and America were together, but Russian administration policies created differences and America and England then were separated. A strong competition, as I said, Cold War was nothing but a pure form of like increase and upgradation of arms and ammunition secretly. So America and Russia both started developing their own upgraded missiles and arms and ammunition. So America and Russia to establish supremacy over the world emerged after the Second World War. The power was centralized between two poles, America and Russia. Therefore, this time period is considered as bipolar world order. Owing to extremely tense relations between two power blocks, this phase is known as the Cold War phase. At various incidents, both the superpowers almost came into conflict with one another. इसका मतलब है कि बहुत बार इसमें कॉन्फ्लिक्ट्स के वजह से ये दोनों सुपर पावर्स आमने सामने भी आए, और इस पूरे फेज को बाइपोलर वर्ल्ड ऑर्डर भी नाम दिया गया, और इसे हम अभी कोल्ड वॉर फेज के रूप में पढ़ रहे हैं। देर वॉज अ बेसिक चेंज इन रिलेशंस अमंग पावरफुल नेशंस ऑफ द वर्ल्ड आफ्टर द वर्ल्ड वॉर। अमेरिका एंड द सोवियत यूनियन who had once allied and fought against the Nazi Germany and the fascist Italy emerged as leader of two rival power blocks and military power. Thus the Cold War started between them. Though Britain and France also had emerged victorious, yet they lost the status of great powers due to terrible reunions caused by the ravage of war and ending of imperialism. Germany, Italy and Japan not only lost the war but also were ruined economically, politically and militarily. After the war, the Soviet Union, Russia, captured the eastern areas of Germany and other eastern countries like Austria, Albania, Hungary, Yugoslavia, Czechoslovakia, Poland, Romania, Bulgaria, and the Baltic states. Later on, they gave away reins of power to respective communist parties of those countries. They did this to continue their superiority on these countries. So, there was also a change in relations among the powerful nations after the World War. America and Russia, who fought together, allied against the Nazi Germanies and fascist Italians, now they too were divided and were the rival power in military powers. So, thus, the Cold War started between them. The Britain and France also had emerged victorious. After the World War, Britain and France also emerged as victorious, but yet they were not able to continue the status of great power, or we can say superpower, as they were ruined by socially and economically. Germany, Italy, and Japan not only lost the war, as Nazis were Germany, Italian, and Japanese. They didn't only lost the war, but they also were ruined very badly through economically, politically, and militarily. After the war got over, Russia captured the eastern area of Germany and other eastern countries like Austria, Albania, Hungary, Yugoslavia, Czechoslovakia, Poland, Romania, Bulgaria, and the Baltic states. Matlab, युद्ध खत्म वॉर खत्म होने के बावजूद भी वॉर खत्म होने के बाद सोवियत यूनियन यानी रशिया ने जर्मनी के ईस्टर्न पार्ट को बुरी तरीके से कब्जा कर लिया, जिनमें ऑस्ट्रिया, अल्बेनिया, हंगरी, योगोस्लेविया, जैकोस्लेविया, पोलैंड, रोमानिया, बल्गेरिया एंड द बाल्टिक स्टेट्स थे. इन कंट्रीज़ को उन्होंने कैप्चर कर लिया, लेकिन लेटर ऑन उन्होंने उसे वापस अपने एक पावर दे दी और कम्युनिस्ट पार्टी को वहाँ की सत्ता दे दी. ये उन्होंने क्यों किया? ये उन्होंने इसलिए किया था कि वो इन कंट्रीज़ पे अपना सुपरियॉरिटी यानी कि वो अपनी ताकत का वहाँ पे ताकत अपनी शासन बनाए रखे इनडायरेक्टली. बाय कंडक्टिंग अ न्यूक्लियर टेस्ट द सोवियत यूनियन चैलेंज द मोनोपोलिस्टिक nuclear power of America. Meanwhile, democratic system was gradually established in the Eastern European countries that were liberated by British and American forces. By conducting the nuclear test, Soviet Union, मतलब रशिया ने nuclear test conduct करके directly superpower America को उस वक्त challenge किया था. Meanwhile, democratic system were gradually established in the Western European countries that were liberated by British and American forces. So, उस वक्त democratic system America and European countries में लागू हो चुके थे. Democratic ways is just like in India, we have democratic system. तो ये यूरोप और अमेरिका में लागू हो चुके थे. So students, today we have studied about Cold War. I hope you all have understood what is Cold War and what were the consequences and reasons for Cold War. In next video, we will continue this chapter and cover the world distributed among army groups. Thank you.